Art in any region is representative of its culture. The lesson landscape of the soul pertains to the essential differences between Chinese and European paintings. The author compared how the purpose of creation of artwork differs among these two cultures. Two interesting examples were used to illustrate this. According to her, a Chinese painter intended for the viewers to see the creator's mind through his paintings, while Western paintings reproduced an actual view based on delicate realism. The lesson also contains a report from Hindustan Times about art brut or raw art. The Indian amateur artist Nek Chand's work has been mentioned in detail here.
Good morning, students. Today we will study the chapter Landscape of the Soul. This chapter has three stories and a comparison between the Chinese art and Western or European art. And the most interesting part of this comparison is that yoga is also mentioned in relation to the Chinese art. Let's see the first story. A medieval Chinese artist, Wu Daozi, lived in 8th century. The emperor of that time asked him to paint on the palace wall. Daozi hid his work behind a screen. Apart from Daozi, only the emperor could see that painting. When the emperor saw the painting of Daozi, he admired the scene of forest, mountain, waterfalls, clouds, birds in the sky. Daozi told emperor that a spirit lived in the cave that was at the foot of a mountain. He cracked. The door of the cave opened. The inside was also splendid. The painter, Daozi, entered the cave. The king also tried to enter the cave, but failed. The door closed. The painting also disappeared from the wall. The artist was never seen again. Probably, it was his last painting. Chinese philosopher like Confucius and Zhuangzi wrote such stories revealing the spirit in which art was considered in China. Now the second story. There was a famous painter in Flanders. He did not draw the eye of a dragon in his painting because he feared that the dragon would fly off. And the third story. It is a 15th century story from Antwerp. Antwerp is a city in Belgium now. There was a blacksmith. His name was Quentin Metsys. He loved the daughter of a famous painter. But the painter was in no mood to approve of their marriage. So Quentin one day got into the studio of the painter and painted a fly on his latest canvas. It looked so realistic that painter tried to drive it away. Now the painter realized the latent painter, hidden quality of a good painter in Quentin. He accepted Quentin as his trainee and made him his son-in-law.
The lesson tries to bring out the contrast in art between East and West. Teachers had always enjoyed an esteemed position in the East. The author mentions how the books of great Chinese philosophers and teachers like Confucius and Zhuangzi were used by teachers of the East to orient their students to the right directions. The story of 8th century artist Wu Daozi is mentioned to explain this. The painter wanted to show the emperor the spirit dwelling in the cave in his painting. And unbelievably, the artist entered the cave and its entrance closed. Immediately, the painting itself vanished from the wall. This story reveals the spirit in which art was considered in China, that the work of art was a reflection of the spirit of the artist. He was the art that he had created. All his work was aimed at revealing the mysterious works of the universe. In the next class, that will be the concluding lecture on this chapter, we will analyze and interpret this chapter as a whole. That will be the crux of this chapter.